I'm taking the journal title. Now, it gives me information even about this journal. For example, it tells me about the title of the journal is Construction and Building Materials, its ISN number, its URL, the website web link that from which you will get the online access to this journal and the publisher. Now, what is the publisher policy? It even discusses that. Now, open access pathways permitted by this journal policies are listed below by article version. So what do we need to do is we can first of all look at the various pathways through which this journal goes through, which I have already described. There are at least four phases through which any journal goes through. First of all, it accepts your manuscript. Then it checks the plagiarism. Then it sends to the reviewers. And finally, there's a revision and the acceptance or the rejection. Now, this is the policy which is mentioned here. Published version this is the policy, and the accepted version, this is a separate policy. Now, in published version, there are three policies. I'll just mark them up. There are three policies which this journal has. Let me take just a minute. Now, this is the published version. This is the published version. This is the published version. Then there are accepted versions. These are the accepted versions. Now, in published version, one of them is this is non-commercial repository. Second one is institutional repository. Repositories are where you are keeping. Now, the non-commercial one, it's not commercial. Institutional, it's university level, research organization level, or any other institutional which is government owned. Now, the third one is again institutional repository, subject repository, research for development. Now, there might be a slight difference between these two. And in the accepted version, it has certain features wherein you can now there are two features, REPEC. I have to recall what this is, and the second one is institutional repository. Now, this is giving you actually the pathway. In published version, you might have two more versions. The first version, maybe it's just online version. The second one is offline version. These are the published versions. Now, it can be preprint. What is preprint? You are getting an online version which has not gone into the printing yet, neither into the publishing. So the journal can offer this. Again, an offline version, there can be a preprint copy that may be available to the author. In online version, there can be a published one. So then the second path comes to be accepted. So first of all, in published versions, you have online as well as offline. Then online itself can be both published as well as accepted. Dono ho sakte hain. Online version mein aapko preprint bhi milega and offline version bhi mil jayega. Both can be preprint as well as postprint or printed versions, which you call. Then online version ke do aur kisme hain. It can be published as well as accepted. Similarly, in offline version, you have published one and accepted one. So this is the, there are, now what is the difference between published and accepted? Which one comes first? Does acceptance come first or the publishing comes first? Which one will come first? It will be the acceptance that will come first. Once your paper is or manuscript is accepted by the journal, what will happen with that? It will go into preprinting. Once that is done, pehle acceptance milegi aapke paper ko, then it will go into preprinting, then it can be available online. And this feature comes even before it's available offline. And because it's much easier for the journals to make it available online. But this is not published yet. Available to hai online, but it's not publishing it. Means, uska matlab ye hai, ye website pe dikhai de raha hoga. I'll just show you an example. Let me take the same journal, Construction Building Materials. Now, what does this journal mention? What does this journal mention? It's a Construction Building Materials journal. It's available open access as well as subscription. So now gold open access articles are freely available to both subscribers and the wider public with the permitted reuse. This is what I was talking about when I told you this afternoon that aap jab ek acche journal mein bhi, which is available from the Elsevier, it is open access, but with additional payment. It's gold open access. You are actually paying for the publication to be made public for a wider audience. For the audience, it's available free of cost. They can easily access this paper. So it's up to you. And when this is not open access. Now this is subscribed. So this is the first option that you get here on this journal's page. Next, the journal is mentioning its editor. It's mentioning its site score, its impact factor. Article publishing charge is this much. Now this is when this journal offers authors the option to publish their research on open access. Now, this is a charge when you want to your paper to be an open access publication. So, what I was talking about, I was giving you an example. I wanted to highlight this, what is published and what is accepted. So, let me go into this. Now you can see here, I want to explore this journal content. There's a latest issue. There is an article in press. So this is not published yet. This is what I was talking about. An article which is still in press. It's not published, but it's available online. Ye paper available hai online. This is the article, for example. Now you can access, you can purchase the PDF right now. Because I'm not a subscriber right now of this journal. So I have to get the access. But if I pay, if I have the institutional subscription, access through my institution, I can access this paper. So this is not yet published. This is in press corrected proof. So the proof read has been corrected. This has been accepted. So the first thing that has been done, that this paper has been actually accepted. Next, it has gone then into the press, but it's still not published. But it's available online. It's available online. So it's still in the loop for publishing. So the next step, then it will go into the publishing. So this journal follows both the policies that it makes the paper available soon after acceptance, although it has not been published. Publishing takes time. Now, there are certain journals, what they do, this is for your information, not related to this course. What they do is that they make the paper available online. They make it available online into a single basket, and that's available. They mention something like this. What they do, wo aise mention karte hain, it's available first online. But apart from that, they also, these are papers which may be accepted now. They are accepted now. And they mention that this will go into the publishing, say, after 4 months. Let me give you an example. What they do. If I get it somewhere here. Okay, let me check whether this journal has got this policy. Right. For example, this is volume 280 of this journal. Now, what is the volume here? This is April 2021. That has still not come. This is, right now we are into the Feb 2021. This is April 2021, but this is published online. If I check this is download full issue. I can download it at the present, but this volume will be actually published in April 2021, which is the offline version of this. So these papers, jo ye wale papers hai, they will all come in the publishing, in the offline, as well as online, jo inka version niklega. It will come in April 2021, but it's available beforehand. It's available beforehand right now under this volume number, and you can easily cite it right now. Lekin ye future date ka hai. This is of April 2021. Now, the question comes, while you're citing this, ye April 2021 ka hai, and you're writing the paper right now, do you cite this as April 2021, or what do you mention? Aap kya future ka bhi cite kar sakte ho? Because this has not gone into the final publishing, there will be certain change. Ab journal kyun aise rakhta hai? Although it's available on online, but offline print se pehle wo allow karta hai aapko as an author to make certain change. Aur baakiyon ko bhi wo, because these are available to the wider audience, they can check and they can make the corrections. So anybody is free to point out any points about the publication, such that the author again makes those corrections before it goes for the final publishing in April 2021. So aap cite karne ke time pe future date cite karte ho ki nahi? This is a side question that may arise from this discussion. What do you think? Any of you? Any of you who is listening to this lecture, what do you think? When you cite, क्या आप अप्रैल 2021 अभी cite करोगे अपने publications में? Yes.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Walaikum salam, Mohsin.
Yes, sir. Every publishing house after publishing it all after accepting the papers online, they provide their link, site link. Right. So these articles also, sir.
So, mera question ye hai, kya April 2021 ka aap agar apna paper likh rahe ho abhi, you are an author. And now you are citing this paper, any of these papers which are in this April 2021 issue. Right now, will you cite it as April 2021? Because let me check this. If I check this paper, now I'll cite this. Let me cite it from, export the citation to BibTeX. Let me check the citation of this. Now, this is the citation of this. What does it mention? Year is 2021, volume is 280. So, if you're citing this in this form, you are actually citing the, you can actually cite what will be printed or published in April 2021. You can cite it right now. This is what my question was. Is it right to cite it this way?
If sir,
Hanji
sir, if a paper is accepted and it has gone through all the processes and there is no fault, then we can cite this paper, sir.
Absolutely, you can cite this, but you have to also mention at the end of it, while you are giving the reference, you have to mention preprint. This is accepted, but it's not into the print. So it's preprint. So in the references, this is for your information. You have to mention, and you should mention that this is in the preprint. So this was about this came up from this published version and accepted version. Now, this website is actually giving you all the information about how the processes go through. For example, it's subscription based, the published version, and then it's published. Let me go through this. There's a fees. This is from the Sherpa website, from which we got the information about the journal. This pathway has an open access fee associated with it. Now, the fee associated, which I discuss, wo wahi fees hai jo agar aapko freely isko available karna hai. And we got that information also from the website of the journal as well. Now, this pathway includes open access publishing. There is no embargo and no there is a particular license that you have, and the location of this journal, it's giving you the location of the journal. So this is for the published version. There is another way of publishing a published version. Then there are certain funders through which this process goes through. So yahi journal bahut sare tareekon se publish karta hoga. Now it might also be publishing with the funding obtained from all these societies. Then in the accepted version, it's again giving you the information. So all the information about the journal is available. Now this was a good journal. Let me check any other journal. This is Devi Publishing. Now, these are particular journals. Now, let me go to journals. For example, you have this journal. Now, this is a paid journal. Now, this sort of a journal is actually, you have to pay for it, even for not it being available as an open access. You have to still pay whenever you submit the manuscript. Although this is a good journal, publishing house. Now, let me get the ISSN number of this. Now, this is the information that you are getting about this journal. Now, it's listed in DOAJ, which is actually the open access journal. Now, there are only three forms available of the journal. It's open access. This pathway includes open access publishing, no embargo, there is a license. So then there is an accepted version. Again, it's open access. So this sort of journal within this publication house is freely available. It's an open access journal. Now it's giving you the information about this. Now Sherpa Romeo will also give you the publishings, not only the information about a single journal, it will also give you information about the publishing by different countries. Now, for example, USA, it has, there. These are the publishers, 1,085 publishers. And then if you compare it with India, it's 152 publishers in India. UK has 653. Now, these are all journals which are mostly good quality journals, which are mentioned here in this website, which are actually indexed and filed here. The database is available here. And the growth of publishers has increased. Now in India, what are the other analytical parameters that you care about while checking the journal? And this is very important for all of you. You have to check through the UGC website, and UGC approved list of journals has now been replaced by UGC care list. This is from 14th of June 2019. So you click on this. Actually, you have to go into the login. I have already logged in. So now there are UGC, this is a QGC care list. Now, this is again based on certain metrics the UGC takes into account. Now, how does that happen? It's based upon, there are committees, UGC care empowered committees. The journal publisher has to actually file for his journal to be into the UGC care list. If it meets all the requirements of UGC Consortium for Academic and Research Ethics, which is UGC CARE, this is a consortium for academic and research ethics. If it meets these requirements, then that journal will come into the care list. Now, there are two types of care lists. UGC care list one, this is the first one. In the first care list, this is care list one, UGC care list group one, this one. Now you have to go and look for the journal. Now, for example, I am concerned with, let me go and check any journal. These are all the journals which are in the UGC care list and which UGC classifies that these journals follow the ethics, the publication ethics. And UGC care list one mein wo wale journals hain jo ki UGC care list two mein, for example, you have those journals which are Scopus and Web of Science and indexed, and in care list one you have those peer reviewed journals jo ki UGC care list two mein Scopus and others nahi hai. Ab care list one mein they are all peer reviewed journals which are not in the Scopus, but they have been accepted by UGC after properly scrutinizing these journals. To isme se, for example, maine dhoond ke nikale, to these are the pub journals papers available in iindex. Now there is certain information given also here that this journal has now been indexed in Scopus. So earlier this journal paper was not in Scopus, now Scopus ne bhi iski indexing ki hai. So that's an added benefit. But there are certain journals, for example, yahan par is journal ke bare mein mention, this is discontinued from October 2020. So how did this discontinuation happen? Every journal has to go on applying periodically har saal unko ya period by given periodicity they have to apply such that their journal authenticity is checked following certain parameters by the UGC care jo unki committee baithti hai. Now they have to apply online, unko online hi apply karna padta hai. Given all the requirements are met, then their license is continued, their authenticity is proven under the UGC care list. Now this journal, for example, it has failed to prove its presence in the UGC care list since October 2020, thereby it's further discontinued from this care list. And again, you have information available like indexed in Scopus. So you have a variety of informations that are available to you when you are checking. Again, this is discontinued from Feb 2020. This is discontinued from Feb 2020. Earlier, these journals were in the UGC care list, but after periodically checking their data, it was found that they no longer qualify to be in the UGC care list. So this was one information about the UGC care list one. Then in the UGC care list two, because we are mostly concerned with science citation index, not in arts and humanities, so we'll be talking about this. There are three, actually. Web of Science mein teen classifications hai: art and humanities citation index, social science citation index, and SCI, science citation index. Apart from that, you have the Scopus source listed journals. We'll be particularly focused on number one, SCI. This is SCI. Now you can go and check, for example, I was checking construction building materials. I was checking this journal. So, and now it gives me that this is in the SCI. It's Elsevier SCI indexed. It gives its address, ISSN number. It's in the Web of Science SCI. It's also additional Web of Science indexes. Essential science indicators are also there. So you can then go and look into the profile page. So this is one information which you are getting from the SCI about the journal. Let me go and check in the Scopus whether this journal is in the Scopus. Now, this journal is in the Scopus. Now, this journal is in the Scopus. Now, if I can click here, it's now giving me the information about the journal that it's from the Elsevier. The Scopus coverage is from 1987 to present. It's giving me its site score, SGS score, and SNIP score. It's also giving me further information about this journal. So, apart from that, you can also go and look into SCI Mago. This is actually a website that is telling you about the journal. It's also analyzing the journal based on various other parameters and deeply analyzing it, its quality. This is SCI Mago. So once I am checking the journal, Construction and Building Materials, it's giving me its H index, first of all. Then it's stating about this journal. Further, it's telling me about in which areas does this come. Further, it's talking about its SJR indexing, year by year, then the citations per the document, which are increasing year by year from 1999 onwards. Both self citations as well as total citations of the journal. And then it's also telling me about the construction and building material. This is in SGR 2019. It's 1.49 is the SGR indexing for 2019. But very important is its H index, and that tells you. Science Mago also gives you a ranking. Now, you can go and check the journal rank from Science Mago. For example, I'm checking any subject area. This is all regions journal. Now, if I had to check into this journal now, this was construction building materials. It's at rank 28 within civil and structural journals. And within indexing. Now, there is a very important thing which you need to know is about SGR indexing. These are Q1 type journals. All of these are Q1 type journals. So they are quality.